My name is Omtelolet Om. My magic number is 1850. Okay, so I'm going to present to you how to solve this equation. Okay. First equation is s plus 1 less than negative 2. So you will get this is your first term. Okay, the second is 2x plus 3, but you get modulus. And as modulus must be less than 3.
Terus.
So you will get from.
You will get the.
You will get the graph. The y-intercept is 3, and the x-intercept is negative 1 over 5. Hey, negative 1.5. Less than 3.
Okay, terus. Cepat.
The last equation is 10 and must be greater or equal to 3. So you will get like this graph, starting from 3 until infinity. Okay, so the final answer is this is your graph. Okay, now we will find the domain and range. So the domain, you will get negative infinity until negative 3, union with negative 3 until 3, and union with 3 until infinity. But the final domain is negative infinity until negative 3, union with negative 3 until infinity. Okay, so for the range is from bottom to upward, negative infinity until negative 4, union with 0 until 9, and union 10.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Memiliki semua sertifikat asuransi 1.517. Okay, this is our function. Question asks us to sketch the graph. Okay, first of all, first step, fx equals to first to x.
Modulus
x. So we sketch the basic graph.
These three points, 1, 1, 1, 0.
This is the first step. The second step is fx equals to in x minus 1 in the modulus. So it is horizontally shift to the right by 1 unit. Then shift to the right. So the point right here moves to here. Go. 1, 2, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. The third step is fx equals to negative x minus 1 in the modulus. So it is reflect at the y-axis. So from this we reflect at y-axis. From here, reflect to here.
Okay.
So we do like this. Fx equals to negative x over 2 minus 1 in the modulus. It is horizontally stretched by a factor of 2. So
negative 4, 1.
And for the last step, is fx equals to negative x over 2 minus 1 in modulus plus 2. Plus 2 is vertically shift upward by 2 units. So we shift all the graph upwards by 2 units. The shape of the graph should be like this.
That's all for me.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Omar Ishraq bin Musa. My metric number is 181592. Okay, this is my question. Before we can solve my question, we need to do this thing. All science teacher tells you. It is here all positive. Here only sine and cosine. Positive. Here is time and cot positive. And lastly, here is cos and sec positive. Okay, back to my question. 2 cosecant 315 power of 2 cos 470 degree minus cot negative 240 degree. Plus, you need to know where is the angle, which is cosec and the quadrant 4 is negative because that's only cos the positive. So the negative, like, so we put negative cosec 360 minus 315 and then cos 210 plus 360 is equal to 570. And then the next step is we have to determine the cot, whether the cot is at odd or even. Which is the cot is the odd. So when it is odd, the negative inside, which is the negative and the angle, will come to outside. So negative cot 240 minus 180. The next step is when we have minus 360 minus 315, it will come cosecant 45 degree cos 210 minus by 118 minus 1 over negative tan 16. Which is cot equal to 1 over time. 240 minus 280 equal to 16 degree. Okay, the next step is 2 cosecant equal to negative 1 over sin 45. Also bring the negative and then power of 2. Negative cos 200 degree, which is at the third quadrant. Which is mean the cos is also a negative sign. So cos 210 minus 118. The next is negative. Negative tan 1 over tan equal to cos over sin. So negative cos 16 over negative sin 16. The next step is we insert the value which is sin 45 equal to square root 2 over 2, cos 30 equal to square root 3 over 2, cos 16 equal to 1 over 2, and sin 16 over equal to square root 3 over 2. And continue when 1 divided by square root 2 over 2, which we get 2 divided by square root 2. And then this remain the same, and this one is we can cut both 2 and we get negative 1 over square root 3. The next step is we square root all the number inside this bracket, which is 2 square root 2 we get 4, and then 2 square root 2 also we get 4, and square root 2 power of 2 we get 2. Okay, this negative I'll put outside to make it more easier, and then negative multiplied by negative will get positive sign. move to the next one is 4 divided by, this is 1, 2. 4 multiplied by 2, we get 8. 8 multiplied by negative, negative 8. And then, remain the same, square root 3 over 2 and plus 1 over square root 3. And then the next step is, we multiply the negative 8 and square root 3 over 2, we get negative 4, square root, multiply by square root 3, plus 1 over square root 3. And then we do conjugate. Conjugate the 3 to make it more easier to understand. So you get negative 4 square root 3 plus square root 3 over by 3. And then we get the same. We get the same denominator, which is we divide by 3 and multiply by 3. 4 multiplied by 3, we get 12, and divide by 3 to get the same denominator. And then we can combine it, become negative 12 square root 3 plus 1 square root 3 divided by 3, which means negative 12 plus 1, we get negative. This is the final answer, negative 11 square root 3 divided by 3.
Okay, that's all from me. 2, 3. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Gatakwa, I'm from the UK. Matching number 181.26. Today, I want to explain about simultaneous equation. 4 power of x divided by 16 equal to 64 divided by 2 power of 5 and log x, y plus 2 equal to 1 plus log x 4. Okay, the first thing, we can simplify this equation. We change it 4 equal to 2 power of 2 and 16 equal to 2 power of 4, 54, 2 power of 8. And then power of 4 in the bottom we bring it to the up and it becomes subtract. So 2 power of 2x minus 4 and 2 power of 6 minus 1. When the base is the same, the base is 2, so we can cancel it and we get 2x minus 4 equal to 6 minus y. Okay, and then we simplify the log, log x, y plus 2 equal to 1 plus log x 4. 1, we can change it to log xx. Log xx plus log x 4, we can combine it, become log x. 4x, 4 multiplied by x, and then when we get the same log, we can cancel the log, become y plus 2 equal to 4x, and then we get the equation for y equal to 4x minus 2, and then we bring this equation to here, 6 minus y, we change the y. We put it 6 minus in the bracket 4x minus 2. We get 2x equal to 6 minus 4x plus 2 plus 4. And then when we simplify, we get 6x equal to 12. Well, if we want to find the value of x, we divide 12 by 6 and we get x equal to 2. When we get x, we change x in here, become 2, y equal to 4.